Thank you, Jeff. First, I want to say that I'm not a propagator of Christ, and not even in Switzerland. I didn't want to hinder the work of the Holy Spirit. I wanted to support it a little bit. That was my only role. Actually, it was not prophetic. It was just real. What you said about Iceland. Iceland is the next. Yeah, it was prophetic. Yeah, I'm sure. it will be next June in a year, and then Estonia will be the next in July. So we have the vision that this national prayer coverage leading to transformation is going all over Europe, and afterwards will be a blessing from Europe to the world. After an introduction, we will see a film on Christ Day that has been done by American friends. So I'm sorry, I'm there in the film also, that it was have been too much work to put me out. But you will get a good understanding that this is not not an event primarily. It is a process. It's a start of a movement. It's a I would say it's a structure put in place, a structure of blessing put in place. And I also, everyone who feels called to participate in these Christ Day processes in Europe and beyond, I will give this film so you can take it with you and share it. I have about 20 copies here. I also have a More Than Chocolate and Cheese DVD on the table, one, and also a PowerPoint presentation, which I will not do in PowerPoint ways now because they asked me to speak freely, but the blue paper is the summary of what I'm going to share. So if you don't have enough, you can go to another table, take one. We have put some on every table. I'm very happy to learn here a new perspective on Europe. Actually, I'm really happy that Jeff focuses very much on the foundation of the European Union, which was based on Christian principles. And that is a new perspective for me in this way. I'm one of the people who regards the Christian European Union as a force against Christianity, which it can become if we are not careful and don't fight in spiritual ways for. I'm also happy that we stress that Europe is the Christian part of the Eurasian continent. Really, Europe has been more formed by Christianity than by the Romans and the Greeks together. And it's very important that we realize there is a redemptive purpose of Europe. I will talk about this. Yes. It is a learning experience for me to be here, to be very frank. Not always easy to digest everything. People like me not tend to agree quickly, but they at least learn. And I was remembered at occasion when my youngest daughter, Seraina, she's a beautiful lady, she still is at home, we have four kids and all, are rockets for the Lord, but she especially is a prayer woman, but she's also very beautiful. So I was very proud when people told me that she looks like me. So I told her this several years ago. Very proud father told, well, people tell that you look like me. Then she said, Daddy, is it so bad? So you see the different perspectives. I understand why she saw it a little bit different, that he looks like me than I. But when I was 60, she wrote a letter to me and said, Daddy, by the way, I don't mind if people tell me that I look like you, which was a big sign of love on her side, you know. So we have different perspectives, and I want to add a new perspective. I not only want to speak about Christ, but what God put in my heart in the late 70s, early 80s, very clearly. He said, if you want to reach Switzerland, you need to have a vision beyond Switzerland. If you want to reach Europe, that was then in end of 80s when I had a bigger responsibility. If you want to reach Europe, you need to have a vision beyond Europe. And this is what I deeply believe. I just came here meeting Beat Rinke, one of our in our staff team. Actually, he had a flourishing student ministry in Basel. And he came up to me, I think it was about 25 years ago, and said, look, so many musical students have come to know Christ. I think I have to relinquish this ministry and start a ministry among musical students. And my heart was trembling. Is this right? And the Lord said, yes, you're always preaching that you have to invest, you have to bless the world in order to reach Switzerland. Now you can prove it that you believe it. And he just actually, that was the start of Crescendo Movement, which is now internationally going. He just shared that they could play music, give testimony to the Japanese emperor and empress, and before the Indian parliament, they have an office here in Budapest. And many times this happened, that the Lord is testing us. Do you really have a vision that is beyond your own small constituency, your small church denomination work, you know? Because we are only as much blessed as we are blessing others. And I want to, I hope I find it. Yeah. I want to read a Bible verse. Actually, it's one of my favorite Bible verses. And it's also very important for Christ Day. It's 1 Peter 2:9. Don't repay evil with evil or insults with insult, but bless instead. This is your calling, so that you might be blessed. We can never outgive God. We can never outbless God. If we want Europe to be blessed, we have to make it to become a blessing to the world. And I have not heard this message enough. That's why I felt I need to tell it here very clearly. We have a very special calling as a missionary continent. Wherever I am, I'm accepted very well. I mean, I saw this happening in the Middle East, in China. Americans gave us freedom, like the Billy Graham Association, CBN, to use their film that they were not able to put into countries to use them freely, like Hiding Place, Corrie ten Boom. We put it in more than 300 culture houses in Cuba. And the Minister of Religion said, yes, we are behind you because you are Europeans and you don't just stick for one church. You are for all the churches. That's why we support you. The same in North Korea, the same in Russia, the same in Mongolia. I tell you, most of my time I'm outside of Europe, but I'm an ambassador of Europe to the world. I feel the more we can do for the world as Europeans, the more we will be blessed. Just last week, a group of Dutch and Swiss people who put internet evangelism on Japanese internet came back, you know. We actually planned it 1 year before. God told us very clearly we have to do it. We formed a cooperation, Europe and Japan, in end of January. In February, we decided that on the 11th of April, the team would go to Japan and they formed a Japanese corporation on their side, and they shared they had never had such a unity. And what happened in the meantime, this crisis happened, you know, and they could stick to the plan. On the 11th of April, they were there putting everything on internet, how we can pray, to which God we can pray. Is it still a God of love? What about crisis, suicide, trauma? We put many testimonies of people who survived the Kobe earthquake on internet. Europe, sorry, we have a special calling. And if we don't take this serious, we will be judged. We have a lot of gifts. We are rich, even in Eastern Europe, we are very rich. And now the Americans have difficulty in ministering. We have to step into this gap. We have to have a vision beyond Europe. Then God will also touch our continent because he loves Europeans. He loves the whole world. He wants his glory to cover the whole earth, as I read in the beginning. He wants to heal our land if we are repenting, seeking the Lord, and also repenting of our pride. We need people outside of Europe to strengthen our faith. We need, thank you, Africans. I met someone yesterday, he's residing in Biel, Switzerland. I met someone who's residing in England, a prayer warrior, coming from Africa to bless us. We need Americans. What we need is simple faith in the Word of God again. What we need is that we trust God for the impossible. And that is what we lack in Europe. It's a problem of Europe is not the lack of faith on the side of the unbeliever. It's the little faith of the believers. That's a problem of Europe. God loves Europeans as much as he loves continents where there is revival. That's why I believe. I have not a hope for Europe. I have an expectancy, which actually is the Christian term for hope, as we have heard. So hope in a Christian way is expectancy. Certainty that God will do it because he loves the Europeans. We heard it many times. And I challenge you to have a bigger vision than Europe. I challenge you to give away, to share your riches to the world. It's amazing what you can do with small money. With $20 in Cuba, we support at the moment 550 church founders in Cuba with small money. But they can work because of this. And I could give many, many, many examples. But we have to pay a sacrifice. We have to first see the world and then Europe. But also now, of course, I have also a love for Europe. And I have a love for Switzerland. I'm Swiss. But I have to say that Switzerland is too small. The vision for Switzerland is too small for me. This sounds presumptuous, but it is true. You know? When I was in student ministry, I said, Lord, I just don't want just with a few students. When I was in Russia preaching at a soccer stadium, I said, I'm fed up with just a soccer stadium. And he opened a TV. It's still going on, 28 TV stations. We have to believe God that he opens doors because he loves the people. And now I want to share something where I'm really not much involved. I just let it go. This is Christ Day. Now we want to see this film. American team did it because they believed it could inspire other countries to do the same. But again, I want to say I feel very humbled. I'm not a propagator of Christ Day. It's just God's doing, and I was just in the middle of it, watching it and a little bit supporting it sometime.
Swiss people are driven by the lure of material success, there are others who have opened their hearts to God. They long to see God's kingdom firmly established in their country. On June 13th, they gathered in the soccer stadium in the city of Basel.
I wish that every person in Switzerland would be aflame with the fire of Christ, and that we as Christians would stand up for Jesus.
I wish that this event would first have an impact on Christians in our country, leading us to live out our faith with unconditional love and conviction, equipping us with a new sense of power and hope.
Called together by Christian leaders from throughout Switzerland, Christustag drew believers from every corner of the land. Nearly 45,000 gathered, representing the four official languages and the cultural diversity that is Switzerland.
Sondern ich glaube, dass das Reich Gottes besteht aus Menschen, die Jesus gern haben.
Mais je crois que le royaume de Dieu est composé de personnes qui aiment Jésus-Christ.
Drawing upon the promise of Proverbs 11:11, through the blessing of the upright, a community is exalted, they came to ask God to bless their land.
About 20 years ago, I asked the Lord, what is on your heart for Switzerland? And he impressed me and our leaders in our ministry with two goals we should pray for. First, that our country would become a blessing to the world again, that we would share our riches, and that spiritual rivers would flow out from Switzerland to the world. And he also impressed us to pray and to work for the second goal, that in every political community, in every district, there is a cell, a community, that is praying regularly and intensely for the community, for the district, for the authorities as well as the inhabitants.
Switzerland is divided into 2,800 political districts. A truly national prayer movement would involve men and women of every district. But would that be possible? Would everyone be represented? A website was established to track the responses from throughout the country. God began to work in people's hearts, and by the day of Christustag, every district was represented, every representative carrying their district flag as a symbol of unity and their commitment to pray. The vision was fulfilled.
The normal, just the normal Baptists, the normal Pentecostals, the normal Methodists, they saw it. They saw it on internet. Oh, they said, something is happening in Switzerland. We need to be part in this. And they also committed themselves to pray for their district.
For over 500 years, Switzerland has been known for its commitment to diplomatic and military neutrality. However, in the affairs of God's kingdom, the body of Christ in Switzerland is united and on the march. Through Christustag, God has launched a committed prayer offensive in Switzerland that has united and energized believers to see, pray, and work toward a spiritual awakening in their land.
Merci pour la bénédiction que tu as fait reposer sur notre nation tout au long des siècles.
Signore, siamo qui per chiederti di benedire la nostra nazione.
Herr, bitte vergib uns, wo wir dich ausgeschlossen haben und unsere eigenen Wege gegangen sind. Wir haben deine Hilfe nötig.
Wir senden euch im Namen von Jesus Christus, dem Herr der Herren, dem König der Könige.
Everyone worked together, hand in hand, like at the time of Nehemiah. When Nehemiah built up the wall together with the people of Israel, everyone built at his place, opposite of his house. This is exactly what happened in Switzerland. That from all these 2,800 communities, people stood up and said, we want to do something against the negative trend of our society. We want to stand up and pray and bless the people and take God's promises. And we want to unite with the brothers and sisters in our community.
What happened in Switzerland is just a taste of what God could do throughout the nations of the world. As God chose to touch a small country tucked away in the majesty of the Alps to show His power, He can work in other nations to join together believers in a committed spirit of faith, unity, and reconciliation. Christustag, praying for everyone, until everyone knows someone who truly follows Jesus.
You don't see, but twice, it was not a nice day, but twice the flag bearers came on the soccer field, and both times the sun broke through totally, and it was unbelievable. And when the flag bearers, I watched when they came off the soccer field, at least half of them were praying, were weeping. Just normal men weeping, you know. Many told me, you know, God touched me when I was there. And I didn't realize beforehand the awful responsibility I have for my community. But now I take it. And they are still doing it now, after years. And the last Christ Day, I had the same, I was also responsible for the program, just last June, 25,000 people stood up and said, we want to open our homes for strangers now, as a follow-up. So it's going on, you know. And I think, you know, Switzerland is very secular. We have, maybe now we have 5% who attend churches, not more. Before, maybe 2-3%. But what we see is a heaven that is open. If you come to Switzerland, it's easy to pray. You just have to pray. And we want to bring in the whole harvest the next years, and not just in Switzerland. This has happened in Finland. There is, unfortunately, on the PowerPoint there would be pictures of Finland, where you see 30 leaders standing in the front asking for repentance according to 2 Chronicles 7:14. I counted, it was 48 minutes, and it was not boring, although I counted it, because I said this will not work. If you have 30 leaders pray after another, this will go 3 hours. But actually they had 1 minute and they did 48 minutes, so they did a little bit more, but they really, it was so such a deep prayer of repentance, you know. And the same again, the flag bearers formed a cross, and now everywhere you see evangelism happening in Finland. The same is being prepared now in other nations, as I said. And I believe many prophetic people have shared to me that they saw crises jumping up all over Europe, some nationals, some regionals, and even beyond. And so I tend to believe, but it is God's doing, you know. But maybe you feel called, you know. You just are this person where the Lord is telling to you, I looked for a man, a woman, among them who would build up the wall and stand before me in the gap on behalf of the land. It only takes one person, like Schumann, like Adenauer. There were two, okay. But it was good, you know. You can only be united if you are at least two. And then you might be the person who goes to the other leaders and you say, you see the trouble we are in here in Budapest. Budapest lies in ruins, or Jerusalem, or Zurich. And its gates have been burned with fire. Come, let us rebuild the wall of Jerusalem. After Chicago in 95, we started to assemble 7 leaders of the biggest denomination, Evangelical Alliance, myself. I just felt we need to come together to just pray, share, pick up mushrooms, share life, bless each other. And we have done it now for 17 years. We are still doing it. And 7 years ago, people said, we also want to be involved, so I invited all the leaders of the different language groups too. There are people here who are in this group. I just had breakfast with Katrin Larsen, who led Mothers in Contact, a movement that is growing up to 1,500 prayer groups in Switzerland now. And she is now coordinating it all over Europe. She shared about her excitement to do it in Romania and other countries. You know, just another sign of what God is doing, you know. 1,500 prayer groups who pray for the schools. And she also is a part of this leadership prayer. I think it's very crucial, you know. Jesus connected the effectiveness of the propagation of the gospel with the love among his followers, John 13, 34, and the unity, John 17. And I feel these days are about unity. You understand? It's about serving one another. So we have to serve one another. We have to serve the poor in the world. And they serve us with their faith, with their prayer. I'm so happy. I tell you, all coming from outside of Europe, please bring in this harvest. We need you. Hold up our hands. We need you. I've been so blessed by people coming from Latin America, from Africa, from Asia. Even this morning, you know, I walked with someone from Hungary. He blessed me so much. We need each other. We need each to hold up hands. Everyone has to give something. Christ Day is not a mobilization of generals. It's a general mobilization. Yeah, everyone is involved. Everyone fulfills his talk. Everyone, opposite where he lives, he builds up the wall, you know, like at the time of Nehemiah. With his gift, the gifts are different. Some are more in the social justice area, some more in the evangelism area. Doesn't matter. But we have to be involved. We are blessed as much as we are blessing. This is point. And we have to be humble enough to be really great. And great enough to be humble. And one of the humblest person I met was Billy Graham. When I wrote the book on Billy and Ruth Graham, I asked the Lord, why could you trust this couple so much? I want to learn from this couple. He said, study their life and write a book on it. I said, oh, I've never heard Billy Graham preach in a stadium. I have been in the conferences, but not. Said, you just, I help you. And he put us in contact with the oldest daughter and became a friend. And what I learned through the oldest daughter and through meeting Billy Graham, his humility was because he was focused on his relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. It's all about the personal relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. If we are not good on our knees, we are not good anywhere. 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 And if we speak too much about transformation without being daily transformed by the power of the Holy Spirit and His love, we are useless. And one of the big problems of Europe is that we have defined so many methodologies of church growth, whatever, and this is the most biggest obstacle for renewal of Europe and transformation. We have to become humble again, broken again of our own will, and then God wants to use us mightily, because in the end time harvest, Europe will play a very, very important role. And the question is, are you part of it? Am I part of it, or just an observer, just someone who writes about it, positive or negative, or are we part of it? And I finish with this, you know, I was in Germany, I said, Lord, I'm now getting old, please hurry up with revival in Europe. And I want to be involved. I deserve it in a way that I can say this, you know. Because I wrote a book on this 30 years ago already, If My People Praise. And then the Lord, next week I was in a youth conference, and the lady next to me said, you are not so old, you will experience revival in Europe. She didn't know anything about my prayer. Next Sunday I was in a church, someone interrupted the prayer, said, I have a word for Hans-Peter Nüesch, you are not so old, you will experience revival. And that's why I'm starting a revival now. My second book is about revival in Europe. That's the title, Revival in Europe. And at the next conference, I will introduce this book also, if I may. Okay, thank you.